Hi, I'm Dr. A. Santhosh Kumar, practicing as consultant urologist and andrologist at Lux Hospital, Gachibowli, Hyderabad. Coming to the urethral stricture. Urethral stricture is nothing but any scar which occurs in the passage of the urethra. That is, urethra is the tube which passes from the urinary bladder up to the tip of the penis. That is called urethra. It is almost something around 25 to 30 centimeters in length. So whenever a scarring causes in the urethra, either it can be infectious cause or it can cause by a trauma. So whenever a scar causes in the urethra, there is blockage in the urethra. It can be complete blockage or partial blockage. So whenever you have the symptoms of urethral strictures, the most common symptoms what you have is decreased urinary stream and increased frequency, and you may have pain while passing urine. At the same time, few people, if associated with infection, may have hematuria. So with these complaints, whenever they say sometimes actually they want to pass urine twice or thrice, that they are not able to complete the void. So these are the symptoms most commonly present with urethral strictures. Usually whenever a patient present with lower urinary tract symptoms, there are chances if he is a young patient or at the same time if he is an adult patient, there are chances he may have urethral stricture. So usually we diagnose urethral stricture based on his clinical symptoms, how he is presenting and what is the duration of the symptoms. At the same time, we advise few investigations like ultrasonography to look for any post-war residual urine or to look for any stones in the bladder or kidney, ureter and bladder. And we usually do uroflowmetry, which indicates the flow of urine, how significant his void has affected. And the next, what we do if you are suspecting a urethral stricture, uroflowmetry, there is a box pattern in a stricture case. So whenever there is a box-like pattern on uroflowmetry, then we advise RGU, that is called retrograde urethrogram, to diagnose the stricture. So based on these investigations, we can come to a conclusion of diagnosis, like what is the location of the stricture, how bad the stricture is, and what is the length of the stricture. These criteria help us in planning the treatment. So after diagnosing the urethral stricture, we have various options of treatment. Depends on the age criteria, depends on the length of the stricture, depends on the how severe the patient is suffering. There are various options. Either it can be endoscopic operation or either it can be surgical option, which is called urethroplasty. So whenever the stricture is small and not that significantly affecting him, initially we can go for endoscopic procedures, which is called visual internal urethrotomy or endoscopic internal urethrotomy. But if the patient is very young and if he has to get rid of the symptoms, the most ideal procedure for these patients will be buccal mucosal graft or any graft it can be. We can take it from the papules or anything, and we can make it a substitutional urethroplasty. So this is an open surgery what we are going to do. There are advanced procedures like if the patient is unfit for surgery, we can keep balloon dilatation of the stricture, or nowadays we are doing even laser stricturotomy. We use the laser source of energy to incise the stricture and we'll make the passage flow freely. And there are various options what we are going to give based on his symptoms.